In order to have access to our forest for the purpose of forest management, we need basically three components. We need skid trails, we need a log landing, and we need truck roads. Skid trails are the most basic forest management infrastructure. They're trails that are only traveled on by skidders. So skidders, it's like a big tractor, this piece of logging equipment that pulls trees out of the woods. One end is lifted up off the ground, and then the back end of those trees drags or skids on the ground. That's why they're called skidders. So skid trails are pretty rudimentary. Those are the trails that you find as you're wandering through the woods, and it's just sort of a very faint trail through the woods. In order for skid trails to be stable, they need to have good stream crossing locations, so crossing streams at right angles and crossing them as minimally as possible. They need to have water bars. So a water bar is just basically a hump that diverts water off the surface of the trail to the downhill side of the trail. The distance between water bars depends on how steep the slope is. The steeper the slope is, the more that you need. If you don't have water bars, what'll happen is that water will collect on the surface of the trail, build up a lot of volume and a lot of velocity, and eventually wash the trail out. Once we're done managing a forest and the loggers have come back, ideally with an excavator or a bulldozer, put in these water bars on all the trails, and also pulling out any temporary stream crossings so streams can flow freely, we say that a job is closed out, which just means that it's stable. The second thing you need for forest management access is a log landing. And this is where the skidders will basically pull trees down, cut them into different products, so saw logs, firewood, pulp, and the truck will come, turn around, pick them up, and take them off to the mill. The key thing about the log landing, other than being like a big flat area where trucks can turn around, is it needs to be accessible by truck roads. So those are roads that log trucks can travel on. Truck roads are generally the most expensive part of access infrastructure, but if you don't have a good truck road, you basically just can't do commercial forest management, which really limits your ability to do forest management at all. This is what the truck road on my land looks like, and while this can look pretty rudimentary, even putting in something like this is pretty expensive. And so it's really important that you protect it. Truck roads do the same thing that skid trails do, where water collects on them, and if the water isn't diverted off the surface of the road, it can cause erosion and cause washouts and basically cause you to lose the road. Now, you can't have water bars like you do on the skid trails because you need to be able to drive log trucks over them. But a lot of people do, instead of having water bars, is that they have the road crowned. So that means that the highest point on the road is in the center of the road and it's sloped outwards on both sides. That way the water sheds off the road and off to the sides. You also need a ditch, usually on the uphill side of the road. What the ditch does is it catches the water that's flowing down towards the road and prevents it from getting onto the road. And then also, of course, catches the water that's shedding off the road on its uphill side. If you have a ditch, you also need to periodically discharge the ditch. So send that ditch water across the road to the low side of the road. And that's what we use these cross drainage culverts for. If you don't have cross drainage culverts, you end up with too much water with too much momentum, and it can actually erode your truck road's uphill side and wash it out anyway. One of the trade-offs of these truck roads is that you might be collecting a whole hillside worth of water and concentrating it into a ditch and then sending it all through a single cross drainage culvert. These culverts are sometimes just carrying way too much water, and even if they're not causing erosion on the truck road itself, they are causing erosion in the woods or causing erosion further downhill. What you really want to make sure is that if you have a truck road and if you have a ditch, that you're cross draining it regularly. Lastly, truck roads and skid trails do require maintenance. So those water bars will fill up with silt. These culverts will plug up with sticks and stuff like that. These ditches will need to be cleaned out. So no matter what, you have to make sure that you're out there regularly walking your skid trails, walking your truck roads with a shovel in hand, and making sure that everything is functioning. So I view all the forest management that I do to be ecosystem restoration. And one thing that we're recognizing is that the fact that we can make forest management commercial is a real asset because it allows us to do this work at scale. So even if it may seem like a big compromise to deal with these truck roads and these landings and these skid trails, it really can be a very positive thing for our forests.